Hey guys, this is a video about a mod for Civ 4. I'm a Civ 3 channel, this might be a bit unexpected, so before you click away, let me sell you immediately on why this mod is so important. Fall from Heaven 2 is a dark fantasy 4X game, with elements of RPG and adventure games. This alone is extremely unique and it's difficult to think of a game like it. Heroes Generations is like the closest thing that could maybe come to my mind, but that's completely different. But beyond that, this mod could not exist for Civ 3, and it could not exist for Civ 5 or Civ 6 either. A game like this had to have been made for Civ 4. For a game this cool and unique, there was no other option. And that's why I'm going to betray Civ 3, my one true love, and talk about it today. So let me explain what I just said. Basically, there was an extremely narrow window of time for mods in the mid-2000s. The same one that gave us Dota, which has spawned an entire genre of games. At this point in time, modding capabilities for games had become sophisticated enough, but it was before publishers started to lock things down. By the time you get to Civ 5 and Civ 6, they're starting to hard code things, and modding begins to become something that requires access to proprietary software, not just something that anybody can pick up and do. Not to mention that it's increasingly hard for modders to match the bar that AAA games now set, trying to create assets that don't stick out like a sore thumb from the original assets. So, Civ 5 would be too late, but Civ 3 was too early. I love Civ 3 to death, and I've actually made a fantasy RPG mod for Civ 3. I used the tools creatively and made a crude approximation of magic spells and treasure, but Civ 3 doesn't have custom map scripts. You can't give a debuff to a unit in Civ 3. There's just little things like that. Civ 4 gave all the tools and systems needed to the modders in an era where modders were still king. So, this is not the video I set out to make when I downloaded Fall from Heaven 2. This is going to be glowing, pretty unanimous praise. I had played this game maybe in 2009 or so. It was packaged with one of the expansions for Civ 4, and I remember it being pretty good, but it has evolved immensely since then, to the point where all the things that I was intending to critique about it have pretty much been fixed. So let me tell you about it. Fall from Heaven 2 is better at being Civ 4 than Civ 4 is. Some of the systems feel like they were tailor-made for this mod. Civ 4 nerfs expansion, and that's completely fine here, as the focus is more on exploration and specialization. Civ 4's experience and promotion system was a bit much. They actually toned it down in later games like Civ 5 and Civ 6. Here it works wonderfully. You've got these really deep trees that reward you for picking bonuses that are good against your current threats. And promotions are much stronger, roughly twice as strong as they are in the base game. Due to the fact that it's often hard to produce better units, the best units are the ones with experience. And so Civ 4's systems are used to reward you for engaging with the PvE aspects of the mod. And of course, the mage's spell systems are a really cool use of experiences too. As your mages passively level up, they will learn new spells that you can use on the battlefield. The mod also builds on things that people wanted from the Civilization franchise that were not in Civ 4. The maintenance costs from Civ 4 drive me crazy, so I opted to play as the Curiatates faction. They are a sprawling Civ, meaning that they are limited to a small number of functional cities, but those cities are buffed and can use tiles from the third ring. If you're keeping score at home, this was a feature that was added in later Civ games. This was never in the base game for Civ 4. Fall from Heaven 2 was ahead of the curve here. Religion was also kind of a blank slate in Civ 4. The game really needed differentiated religions, otherwise later religions ended up being weak, because the best religion is the one that has spread to the most cities in base Civ 4, and early religions get a head start on that. But here, each religion offers unique perks, and so you can play the one that is best suited to you. In fact, one thing I really like is that if you don't unlock a religion, you still get the free missionary when you research the technology. So even if you don't found the religion, you can still gain access to the powers that that religion gives. Units being given when researching a tech was something added in Civ 4, but Civ 4 did not use it to its full extent. Remember, this mod was made over the course of the last 20 years. They had a lot more time to spitball, playtest, and refine existing gameplay systems. You'll notice things, like for example in this mod, if you join great people to cities, they give you great person points every turn. This makes a lot of sense in terms of gameplay, but also in terms of realism. You had Plato, soon you will have Aristotle. One thing I like is that the mod is brutal and unforgiving. Around turn 12, barbarians start to spawn and they will just kick your ass, and they can just straight up take your cities too. Clearing out barbarian camps gives you short-term goals to work towards that involve using your army and leveling up your units. There are also global raid bosses that spawn somewhere in the world, so you have some long-term goals to work towards as well. Having these goals is where the adventure and RPG elements come into play. You are rewarded for successful battles with better leveled up troops, but barbarians also have lairs which you can explore that offer all kinds of juicy bonuses. They can give you treasures, special promotions, companions. They can even give you quests, like you get a map leading to a treasure chest halfway across the world. You can get a golden age. There is so much incentive to go out and actually use the cool units that this game gives you. One of my memorable experiences while playing this mod was playing as the Sidar faction. All of the factions are completely differentiated mechanically, and one of Sidar's gimmicks is that if your unit gets to level 6, you can turn them into a great person in one of your cities. So this is obviously really cool, but for me, my hunter was really deep into the wilderness when I activated the ability by mistake. And so what I basically had was an escort quest, where all of the animals my hunter had tamed had to get my now powerless hero home to safety. I've talked a lot here about how this mod is very PvE. Some of this is subject to the map template you choose. If you pick a conventional map type, the play patterns will mostly follow that of a normal Civ 4 experience, just with much stronger barbarians. But I can't recommend enough the Erebus 107 map template. This one gives you fantasy realms completely cut off from each other by mountain ranges, or with narrow choke points in between them, often with like a little nifty fortress guarding the pass that you can claim. You'll meet neighbors, but there are big stretches of hostile wilderness between you two, and it'll be a while before you end up in direct conflict with other civilizations. An obvious strength is the lore, the tone, and the flavor. It does really feel like you're in this tiny, fragile fantasy realm trying desperately to survive, but you're slowly growing into an epic, powerful fantasy kingdom, but very unique and individualized. This shines through in the different spells. Some of them, like Scorch, will modify the terrain in ways that aren't obviously good. Like, this one turns plains into desert, which is kind of crappy in a lot of situations, but if you're playing the faction of desert nomads, it gives you a unique way to terraform your land. It's not just powerful, but it makes you powerful in a unique way, and a flavorful way, too. I also like the art in this mod. The title screen has this demon that was stretched to a less than ideal resolution. You got these people from the back jacket of a pulp fantasy novel. God, this is amazing. This is very clearly just the box art from Civ 2 Test of Time. You know that if this kind of fan game was made in 2024, it would be nothing but AI art. But because this was the late 2000s, the art was no doubt acquired in the traditional way, by paying money to some guy on MySpace slightly more than the furries were offering. It was a better, more noble time. If I could offer one criticism, it's that sometimes the clarity suffers in this mod. Like, I got this pop-up, and I have no clue what it means. Like, it did some things, and I had no clue what it was going to do when I clicked on it. But honestly, the focus of this mod is so much on exploration and discovery and mystery. Not knowing things is less frustrating than it usually would be in a typical 4X game. Learn as you go is very much okay here, and it's still rewarding once you already know things and you go back to play the mod again. I'd say that if there were good info sheets and tutorial content, it would be completely fine in terms of clarity. So, I hope you're ready to play this mod. Now let's talk about how to play. There are several versions of the mod, including mod mods. The original Fall from Heaven 2 that was packaged with Civ 4 has limited replay value, and I would recommend against it. I would say dive right in, download one of the mod mods. I would say Ashes of Erebus is your best bet. I will post a link to the Discord for that mod in the description of this video. There are people there who can help you install it. They were very kind to me when I showed up. Ashes of Erebus is loaded with extra features and factions. I found it all to be excellent. The only new feature I didn't like was like the worker upgrades. If you want something more minimal, check out the Naval mod, which cleans up the original Fall from Heaven 2 without doing too much to expound on it. In terms of settings, I'd recommend the Erebus 107 map template. I would strongly recommend the Blessing of Amathion option when you are setting up the game. This was my biggest complaint when I first tried this mod. It's about growing tall, so land quality was important, but generally most of the land was very bad. I would spawn in small realms with only 2 or 3 bonus resources. Blessing of Amathion doubles the resources and improves the consistency of the games you'll play. That's all I have to say today. Go out, download this mod. Currently, I'm on a mission to play a bunch of Civ-related 4X games, with a focus on fantasy and science fiction. Next on my list will be Civ 2 Test of Time, or Sid Meier's Alpha Centauri. If those sound cool to you, consider subscribing to my channel. Cheers. Have a good day.